I'm not sure about how to describe my role in the team. I'm both working within the team, but I'm also like some kind of speaking partner for the team, talking to the business and make sure we do the right thing and deliver it into production. And I sometimes think that my role is to help people grow, to free their to free the spirits and the possibilities of the people in the team, and make sure they use their skills in the right way. I think that if you should have a team and you can choose the right people, I mean, I guess all of you know a lot of people that you know are performing very good. So if you should select your own team, you should pick these people and that people and that people, and you should create your own dream team. And I think if you have that situation, you have no problem at all. They will deliver whatever happens. Whatever situation they have, they will always deliver, and you can make sure they do it without any help. But then I should have nothing here to talk about. Because I think the most situations is that there is a team. You cannot choose the people in the team. Some people perform very good, some people perform not so good. Some people have different kind of problems. You can have conflicts in the team, but the team is there and you just have to accept it. And the team has some problems that they are going to solve, some tasks that has to be done, and we must help each other to do as best as we can. And I think there is a lot of good practices to use. The different methods, you have a lot of different tools, you can work in different ways that help the team perform better. But I will talk about more the soft part, about how people feel and how that affects their work. So it's more like optimizing the performance by influencing the spirit and the feelings of the team. I've written some five very important areas that I think is important to work with. I think I have to change hand. It's more natural to use this to point. So the first one is responsibility. Another one is participation, quality, motivation, and performance. These five areas is very important to work with, to help each other to grow in these areas. And I think you all understand that if we have a person that is more, if we have this as an axis, so this is less and this is more, the more to the left a people is within these areas, they are not feeling so happy and they will, I mean, not doing a very good work. So I think it's all team members' responsibility to help the other team members move to the right part. Okay, I will just do a short diagram. I'm not sure if you can see this, if you're sitting in the back. But here we have motivation. And on the other axis we have, I call it understand the goal. And I think most people can be placed, and all people can be placed on this diagram. If you understand everything you should do, everything is clear, you have a good motivation. So we have one that is up here. I think this is the people that that you would choose if you should have your dream team. But most people are not here. They are in other areas. And on some borders we have a person here. This is someone that he knows exactly what to do, and he thinks everything is clear, but he has no motivation for some reason. I don't know. It can be different reasons. It was very hard with these papers when I had to have the microphone at the same time. So, but this person has some problems here, and I think we need to help him with the motivation, mostly. On the other axis, here is someone that he has a lot of motivation, but he don't understand what to do, and this one is much easier to help reach here, because if you can just make the goals clear, I mean, break things down into small pieces, just like we do in when we have sprint planning and things, when we break down the whole problem. It can be different things that he does and different reasons, but can we help him move here? And that used to be quite easy. We get him to a dream team player. Then we have one or people that are quite low here, and that I think that's a big challenge. There are ways to help these people move in this direction, but it's more tricky, and I'll come to some ideas later on. And most people are somewhere here in the middle. And during my years, I've seen some typical team members. There are not so many, but there is almost someone of them in a team, or at least for some parts. At least if you have a team where people come and people go. In my team, there's a lot of consultants from different companies, so it's... Some people are there for a longer time, but there's always a lot of changes every year. I have one person I call the wet blanket. And I don't know if you've been on a party sometimes where everything is fun, and then there comes one person in and everyone just gets silent. So it's like placing a wet blanket all over the party. And I think this is the case also for software development teams. You can have this kind of person. And for this person, they really need to increase the responsibility, and he's not participating in the team. Okay. I have another person that I call the grumpy one, that is really a problem for the team. A person that is often in a very bad mood. And you can see when the person comes in the morning, and when he comes, you can just see, okay, today there is no production. This is this kind of days. And he also has to work quite a lot to get these people's participation, responsibility to move to the left. And I have another kind of person that I've come across quite often, and it is the expert. The one that you really want to have in your team, that knows everything about the system. But sometimes this person has a very bad attitude. I haven't seen this person so many times, but When I had it, it's a real problem. The person knows everything, so everyone is dependent about this person. Everyone needs to ask him questions and things like that. But if this person has this attitude, arrogant, thinks that everyone else are quite unintelligent, don't understand anything, he will get people feel very uncomfortable, and they will not. I mean, they don't go to him and ask questions because they know that they will have a very bad answer from him. Okay, so that's a little bit about different persons. I've also seen that these areas are varies during the time of the cycle. When you start a project, there's often a lot of confusion. Everything is new. Everything, I mean, the people are talking about everything that should be achieved in the project. But people don't feel that what they really should do, how we should break this down. And some are gets very confused. So I think in this situation, it's very, very important to explain the big picture, to be clear and reduce the scope and explain what we really should achieve and how amazing that will be. One good thing that I think is increasing these areas quite a lot is always to do some very small proof of concept. That could be just a little part, but that uses most features of the system. And if you can do that, you can then tell the team that the worst case is done. Now we know everything works, and they feel comfortable and they start to be very motivated. I think that it's helped me quite a lot of times. So that's a little bit about the problems that we can see in teams. How should we solve this, and how should we get people to come to the right part of these areas? How many of you have kids in here? Okay. If you take the kids and if you want to go to a road trip, you put the kids in the car and you start drive, and it just takes 2 or 3 minutes, then you start to hear, where are we going? Are we there yet? When will we arrive? And a lot of silly questions. At least as a parent, you get things that are very annoying. But I think these questions are exactly the same that almost all people in the team, they don't ask them the same way as the kids, but they will be thinking the same questions. So it's very important to find the answers of all these questions. And it's mostly about finding the goals and make that clear for everyone. And the way to do this, to answer all these questions and get people moving, to increase the responsibility, participation, quality, motivation, and performance, is by asking questions. Asking questions to each other about what we are doing, how, what, who, etc. But I think that can be quite hard. I mean, you cannot just go to a person and start asking a lot of questions. They will think you are a kind of weird person. So I think you need to first create trust. It's very important to get trust between the team members. And this makes it harder to work with a complete new team where people don't know each other. So trust is something that takes time. And to create trust, I think you need to talk to each other. Take coffee breaks, chat about whatever, other interests, and not just work. And after some time, you get more trust in between. And if you cannot create this trust between the team members, there will be some uncertainties. People will maybe if you try to help someone, but you don't have the trust between the two people, they will maybe see it as a threat. They will wonder, why is he asking this question? What does he want? But with trust between it helps a lot. Sometimes you have people that they are just getting stuck. Whatever you try to do, they have no progress. They have some problem they should solve, but they cannot do it. They don't know how to do it. And of course you should help each other, but if that doesn't help, and I've used tried to use, and I think it has been quite successful to try to stimulate this person, then let there be some time in between, and then the result will come. And to stimulate, I do that by asking questions about the solution. How could it be made? How can we solve it? And things like that. And sometimes I got the answer, it's impossible. And then it's not so easy to go forward. But then you have to try to get this person think anyway. So one question you can say in this situation is, if it was possible, how would you do it then? And then you leave that person for some time, and he starts thinks about this. And at least I have seen that they have been thinking about it, and they find the solution. So it seems to work. Another thing that to think about is the connection between the mind, your thoughts and feeling and action, because this is connected. So if you have one person that he has some good ideas, is thinking good things, that person will be in feeling good, and there will be action. And the other way is the other flow. If you have someone that is performing, he's doing a lot of actions, that will make that person feel good, and he will start to think positive thoughts. And that will this will spread in the team. So if you have someone that is doing this, it will spread to other team members. And if you see some that is doing very good job, you can use that to influence the other. And I think it's very important to also to be a role model in this case for everyone in the team, because no one is knowing what you are thinking. People are just seeing what you do and how you act. So even if you are if you come to work, you are in a bad mood. If you try to smile anyway, people will think that, okay, he's happy, and that will make other one feel good. But I think this is one of the hardest part, at least for me, to smile even if I think that things are not so good. So I can say that a smile makes more smiles. That's something that's true. Another thing that when you work with each other is that you should not talk to people judge them of what they are doing. Try to judge them of what potential they have. What can they become? Because then you always will talk to people in a more positive way. And that will also make it easier to work in the team. It's not so much time left, so I think I will go to a summary. I have 11 tips that I think makes the team work better. The team will be happier, and with happiness comes performance. So the first one is to give praise often, every day. Try to be a role model, as I described before. Always support the team. Whatever your role is, if you're just one other team member, if you're some kind of manager or whatever, always support the team. Inject courage. Give positive feedback. That is also something that should be not just when the task is finished. Do it every day. And respect and pay attention to what the person can become. See the potential in every team member. You should involve and invite. And be present, be there all the time. Listen to people without judging what you hear. Let them talk before you give comments and things like that. And try to evolve others' ideas together with them. Even if someone has some idea and you think that's really stupid. But try anyway to talk about this and make them understand how maybe crazy it was, or maybe you understand that it was actually a good idea. So it's very important not just to say it's a bad idea and they will just be in a bad mood. And also try to give challenges to each other. Try to stimulate each other. And it was, as we saw in the first speech of the day, where you had this diagram with the skills and the challenge. So often people are understimulated when they are not performing so good. So try to challenge them so they come in this middle field that we saw in that presentation. So that's my tip, and I think that if you try to use this, it will be much more fun to work in the team. And I will end with the 11th tip, and that is to use three magical words that makes a difference. And these words are very great work. Try to use this every day. Thank you. Do we have time for questions? Okay, in the back.
Or vem?
In the back, you have that question, I think. Okay, sorry. No questions? Okay, thank you very much.